Welcome back to Sous Vide Everything, guys. Today, something very special, and I hope you enjoy it. Check it out. There are many different ways to enjoy short ribs. You can smoke it, you can shred it, and sometimes you can just cut it with a spoon. There are endless recipes for it. Today I'm gonna show you a different take on a classic, and I know that you're gonna enjoy it, so let's do it. And I started with a 3-bone short rib. These are the meatiest one. For this recipe, the more meat, the better. As you can see here, it also has a very good amount of intramuscular fat. With that being said, the external fat is not necessary. And the first thing I like to do is remove it. You'll notice that once I started trimming, you can also see a little bit of the silver skin. That must also be removed. Once my trimming was done, this is what it looks like. To ensure my seasoning was thick and also give a nice flavor, I used a little bit of yellow mustard. This is just a binder, so I applied a very thin coat. Then I season it nicely with salt and freshly ground black pepper. Be sure to season it well and get all the edges. The next step is to bag it up and cook it sous vide. I'm looking for a butter-like texture, and for that reason, I'll be cooking them at 180 degrees Fahrenheit for 16 hours. I got my beautiful short rib ready. I cooked it at 180 degrees Fahrenheit for 16 hours. It should be as tender as butter. Let's take it out. Let's do it.
Using two forks because they are way too hot, I just shredded them to pieces. The one thing that you want to look for is any silver skin that is left and also additional fat. That is totally unnecessary and it must be discarded. But they are so tender that you can just use your hands. And all the cartilage and silver skin, there's no use for it. Just make sure you remove it. Once I was done, I was left with beautiful shredded short ribs. These are just ready to eat, but we're gonna take them to another level. On a saute pan, I added a little bit of avocado oil, threw in some garlic, and a little bit of shallots. I cooked them under low heat. My goal is to get a nice color on them. These burn quickly, so make sure you keep an eye on it. Then I threw them into my short rib mix and mixed everything well. The next step is to spread out some clinch plastic. Then throw in all your short rib mix. Roll everything into a sausage shape. The goal is to remove as much hair as possible. We want a tight log. Once I was done, the next step is to let it firm up on my freezer, and for that, I left it for 1 hour. As a side dish, I decided to make my world-famous sous vide mashed potatoes. And that's pretty straightforward. Just grab all the ingredients, put it in the sous vide bag, and let it cook for 180 degrees Fahrenheit for 2 hours. Once fully cooked, remove it from the water bath and smash everything fine. The great thing about this is that you can keep it in the bag and pipe it out whenever you're ready. The next step is to make a pea puree, and it's pretty easy to do. On a saute pan, I added a little bit of olive oil, threw in some shallots and cooked them until I have a nice color. Again, cook them under low heat because they burn quick. Then I threw in the frozen peas. Remember, exact amount and ingredients always on the description down below. I lightly season them with salt and freshly ground black pepper. Mix it well and cook them until they are nice and soft. Even if you don't like green peas, I urge you to give this a try. Then I put them on the food processor and chop them up until they become a puree. To give a nice smoother texture, I like to add a little bit of olive oil. This will smooth it out, and it is the secret to make it taste creamy. Once I was done, I was left with a beautiful green puree.
As you can see, we have it completely solidified. It's nice and hard, it's cold, which is perfect for us to be cutting it. Because once I do cut it, I'm going to basically be breading it so that we can deep fry it. Now, if it's still cold in the middle when you deep fry it, you want to deep fry in very low heat, right? So that it gets nice and warm in the middle. But if in any case it's still cold in the middle, you can always finish it up in the oven even a little bit more. That's the plan. I'm gonna show you how I make this. Most importantly, we got our peas ready to go, and our mashed potatoes also is ready to go. Now, it's all about assembling everything and putting it together. But I know, it doesn't look that good right now. But watch this. Thank you. All right, everybody, we have our beautiful, wait, do you know what this is, Mama?
No, but it's fancy.
It does look pretty fancy, doesn't it?
What is that? That's like the greenest guacamole I've ever seen.
It's not guacamole.
Oh, okay.
It's something else, okay?
I thought that you put like food color in guacamole or something.
It is pretty green.
It looks fake.
And this is short rib.
Short rib?
Yes.
That's some fancy short rib.
Fancy short rib is a different type of presentation that I wanted to share with the audience. I think it looks pretty cool.
It looks pretty cool.
Yeah. And then obviously you could tell it was deep fried as well. So I mean, come on. Normally, everybody, when you're plating something like this, I would definitely do it directly on the plate, you know? But we're doing it family style to serve everybody together. Super tender when you're cutting it out, everybody. It's falling apart.
Wow. Oh my God. Oh, short rib is amazing.
That is fantastic. That is incredible.
Oh my God.
Mmm.
That's a sin.
Wow. Hold on. I gotta go for more. This one. Wow.
This thing is so tender.
Is it fancy? Yes. Mm. Is it a little bit more extra work to do it? Yes. Is it amazing? You tell me, Mamau.
Yeah.
Wow. That is so tender. I'm telling you, as soon as we cut it open, everybody, it just disintegrates.
I think if it wasn't for the crust, it would have been falling apart.
It would completely fall apart. Absolutely right. And the additional flavor that you put together with the garlic and the onions and the shallots combined together, you can feel every single thing together. Wow, hold on, we gotta go for more.
I'm guessing that this was very marbly, very marbled short rib.
Yes, extremely. Can you feel that fatness?
You can taste the fatness when you're biting on it.
Mm.
It's like, ooh, there's some fat in here.
I think the only thing to elevate this dish even more would be to smoke it a little bit. Mm, imagine if we smoke it in a little bit, Omar.
The meat is so full of fat inside that you're like, you bite
that
meat
and
you...
That sounded dirty, Omar. I like it though.
You have a dirty mind.
No, it's so full of fat inside the meat. That's fantastic. That's right though. It's true.
That's what it is. It's so full of fat that it has such a nice flavor.
It has a lot of fat, but nothing overwhelming.
No, it's not overwhelming. It's a good complement to the flavor of the meat.
Right, because what happened when I cooked sous vide, all those fat and the juices was dumped out from the bag itself.
Oh.
So, but it's a fatty cut. It has a lot of flavor, extremely amount of flavor.
You keep getting back the crust and it's like, it's little soft crunchiness. And then there's like crunch.
Yeah.
And then like there's a crunch and then it's so soft. And it's a very nice mixture.
Even if you don't like peas, you don't taste it so much the puree combined together with the mashed potato.
You don't taste it at all?
It's a combination of both the puree and also the mashed potato that is fantastic. It's not just the peas by itself, and it's not guacamole. But it does look like one. Do you agree?
Yeah, it does look like it.
Look, it is a little bit of work, but it's something that is definitely worth you giving it a try. You can prepare everything ahead of time and then just deep fry it when it's ready to go. I told you that you could put it in the oven to heat it up, but it was not necessary because it was still hot inside and we've been filming for a little while, okay?
You're still warm.
It's still warm inside.
And it's been sitting here for about like 15 minutes.
Yes, we gotta get all of our shots, right? And it's still nice and hot. So you could put it in the oven and even keep it in there even hotter for whenever it is that you wanna give it to your family members. This is fantastically, and we recommend it. I recommend it, you?
I recommend it.
Man. It's amazing, everybody. Mashed potato sous vide. If you've never done it, what it does is concentrates the potato flavor. There's no washout. There's nothing being boiled.
There's no water to wash the
flavor out. Exactly. There's no dilution of anything. Everything is concentrated deeply, everybody. So the mashed potato tastes a lot better making it sous vide versus the traditional way. That's why I do it, and I wouldn't make mashed potatoes any other way, unless I'm in a hurry.
Plus, you get to pipe it out.
And you get to pipe it out. That's right, Mama. It's gonna be the very first time you're gonna finish the food before the actual video is over.
We're finishing this before the food, we're done recording.
As you can see, Mama is pretty much done with it. Huh? It's gonna be the first time we're gonna finish a video with the food completely gone before we finish it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do enjoy this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you're not a subscriber, be sure to subscribe for future videos. Remember, if you are interested in anything I use, everything is always in the description down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next one. Take care, buddy. Bye-bye.
Yeah.